Hey guys, what is up? This is Owen May from A to Z Reviews, and I'm here talking with Andy Yoshida from Lancer Tactical. Now, Andy, can you tell us, just introduce yourself. Tell us something about you.
So my name is Andy Yoshida. I'm the sales and marketing manager for Lancer Tactical. My background, I started in the paintball industry and played paintball, worked in the paintball industry for a long time. Slowly got into the airsoft industry. One of the main reasons is I like firearms. And so basically, I get to play with toys every day, Yes. So it's a fun thing. It's a sport that, similar to like paintball, where we could actually go out there and play. And, because it's not something that's going to, cause a lot of harm, we could actually shoot it at each other. I know in the firearm world, it's a little bit kind of a weird concept, but you could actually shoot these at each other. But more importantly, just recently, I got together with this guy in Kentucky, Ed White, who runs the Metal Madness Shooting Sports. And it's a 22 rimfire shooting sport. And he created an airsoft version of that. So now we're actually working with actual shooters, and they're using airsoft to train, in their garage. So they don't have to necessarily go to the range and shoot, they could actually shoot in their backyard.
Kind of got interested in that.
So been doing a lot of things.
So what started Lancer Tactical, what got Lancer Tactical together?
So Lancer Tactical, so our company or umbrella company is named KTT International. KTT International started to import products back in 2005. And as Airsoft continued to grow, they started bringing in higher and higher end products. We started off with the very inexpensive spring Airsoft products. And then in 2012, we created our own brand, Lancer Tactical. Lancer Tactical since then has grown. I would say right now we, in the United States, we have to be the largest distributor for entry to mid-level range guns. Lancer Tactical has grown significantly. The other thing that we've done this past year as well.
What do you use? But you talked about starting in paintball and coming over to airsoft. Do you still shoot a lot?
Are we talking real firearm or are we talking airsoft?
Airsoft.
Well, the thing with airsoft and any job, when I go out and play, it's more for like research and development. I'm just testing stuff out. Unfortunately, because I'm in the industry, I cannot play to the degree that I want to play, right? I can't be that aggressive guy. And I'm very competitive. And, unfortunately, people that are competitive, sometimes a different side will come out. I'm trying to be very politically correct, but a different side of a person will come out. Because I'm in the industry, I can't be that guy. I have to be the nice guy and, do everything I can to be positive. So when I go out there with my friends, we're just out there messing around. We don't go and play seriously. But with airsoft, there are some levels where people are very, very serious. There's kids out there, there's grandparents out there, there's all kinds of age limits, so depending on what your levels are or what you want to do, you can find that in airsoft. So I usually try to find the happy medium where I'm playing aggressively but not, I'm not that aggressive, so that the very competitive side doesn't come out. It's a balance that I have to do.
Yes, sir.
But when it comes to guns, yes, obviously, just by bias, I shoot everything that I shoot is from Lancer, right? A couple of different reasons. Yes, I work for here. Two, I get to shoot whatever I want, right? I just go down to our tech department. I just grab whatever I want and I can shoot it. So there's really no point for me to invest in other people's products. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, I you know, it is a little bit of a bias because I work here, but yes, everything I shoot is Lancer.
So going back to you brought up like firearms. So do you shoot a lot, keep your training up, especially with you being like an airsoft guy? I don't know if.
Yeah. So California is a, I hope we don't get Zuckerberg, but it's a communist state, as I'll say very lightly. Kind of give you an idea right now. I saw this morning on TikTok, there's a gas station that's not far from my house. 91 octane is $7.25.
Jesus.
Yes. Right. You know, so it's very expensive. Unfortunately, here in California, there's a lot of firearms that we can't get that you guys could get everywhere else. I started shooting when I was about 16, you know, have, you know, many different rifles, pistols. My favorite round to shoot is 45. You know, my favorite gun to shoot is a Springfield. I have a Springfield Army stainless steel 1911.
Yes,
right. You know, it has some, I had a gunsmith do some work on it. So, you know, as you guys know, a 1911 out of the box, for the most part, they work, but they're not the greatest.
Yes,
I have a little bit of work done to it. So I have some work done to it. But I like, to be honest, I like single stack 1911s. That's like my favorite.
Original.
Yeah, there's a lot of other guns that out there that I wish I could have, but unfortunately, in California, we can't have. I'll tell you one story about a firearm that I think everyone listening is probably gonna say, wow, I made a big mistake. But this was when I was in my early 20s. I thought I wanted to get married. I went to a friend of mine he's a gemologist. So I went to go see him for the diamond. And before I made that purchase, he says, hey, I'm gonna show you something. I said, okay. And he says, I'm gonna warn you as a friend, you should not buy this. If you get caught with this, there's 5 felony counts for this particular gun. I said, okay, now I'm interested, right? Yeah. So he pulls out an H&K SP-89, which is basically the civilian version of the MP5. Mm-hmm. It had a select fire, threaded barrel, folding stock, and a can. Never been shot. Here's the part. At that time, he was only asking $2,100.
Hmm.
Now, I'm sure if you can even find that now, I'm sure it's going to be upwards of 10 grand, probably higher.
Yeah.
In California, obviously, we can't get it. We can't even get anything close to that. But yeah, I made the big mistake of choosing an engagement ring over this gun.
Wow. And obviously, the
engagement broke off.
So, colossal mistake.
I got screwed both ways.
Yeah. Colossal mistake. Yeah. Yeah, but I don't know why, but I looked up MP5 prices and they are raising by the day.
Mm-hmm.
It is almost impossible to get.
It's an old design, but it's still a sexy looking gun.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I don't think one person that shoots will tell you that the MP5 looks terrible. Not one person.
Yeah. I would agree with that.
So, going back to being in California, is airsoft is a lot more popular in California since the gun laws are a lot, harsher? Or,
you know, I would say in the early days, probably, right? And that's only because of the fact that in California, we have the Port of Long Beach and the Port of Los Angeles, and 95% of airsoft product come from Asia. So basically we have the ports here. So a lot of the manufacturers and distributors are here in California for airsoft. So I think back in the days, I would probably say, yes, California was probably had the biggest amount of airsoft players. But, you know, across the country, you know, it's grown tremendously. You know, for example, I really believe in the Atlanta area, there's a very big population of airsoft players there. Same thing with Florida. If you go to like the Midwest, you know, if you go like, you know, Chicago area, there's also a big area over there, New York, New Jersey, you know, a lot of players. So like I said, I think in the early stages, yes, California was probably where we had the biggest amount of player base, but I think through time it kind of spread out. And I think it's pretty equal across the US. You know, obviously Wyoming and Montana, you know, the population isn't going to be, isn't dense. But any major city, there's usually at least an outdoor field, and there might be an indoor arena as well. So you get a little bit of both of that.
Yeah, I didn't, honestly, I never played a professional airsoft game, and I didn't know how big airsoft is getting. It is getting huge.
Well, it is, you know, a lot of different ways. You know, obviously it started off as a sport where, you know, kids are running around shooting each other. You know, that's kind of how it started. But now, especially with the cost of ammunition going up, there's a lot of law enforcement that are actually using it for force on force training. You know, simunition is expensive. Simunition also hurts. I'm not sure if you've ever been shot by simunition, but it's not fun. You know, there's a place in Las Vegas that actually lets you go out there and shoot simunition at each other. And it's not a fun thing. I've never done it personally, but I've seen people do it. I've seen the aftermath of what happens when you get hit with it. Not fun.
Yeah, I've heard about it. It's not a fun day.
Yeah, so a lot of agencies, or not a lot of agencies, but there are some agencies out there that are utilizing airsoft as an alternative. Because it is, you know, less expensive, and it's also less painful. You still get the feeling of getting shot. You know, there's still a little bit of a pain factor. So it's not like you're shooting a laser at each other. Yeah. So you actually get, you know, the sensation of getting shot, obviously not like really getting shot, but, you know, you do have that adrenaline that comes with it. So,
yes, sir.
You know, like a lot of the law enforcement that we've been talking to are slowly starting to switch over to airsoft for training.
Yeah, that's really interesting, actually, because my local police department actually just started doing airsoft. I know a couple of cops out here, and they started doing airsoft for different training exercises. And they say it's so much more fun when you aren't bullet counting and going out there, and they give you 100 rounds to try to get your to try to file down your skills, and it's just a lot more fun when you don't have to worry about that kind of stuff.
Yeah, and you know, going back to that, there are, you know, a couple of indoor arenas that I know of, like in Northern California, there's one big one called US Airsoft, and then there's one in Stockton called CQB City. And both of those facilities, that the owners there allow the local law enforcement to actually do training in there. You know, the one in Anderson, which is US Airsoft, I had the opportunity to go visit them one time. And it's an outdoor field, but they have a building with a kind of like an indoor CQB setup. And it's about, I think it's like 30,000 square foot building. And the day that I was there, they were actually doing canine training. And, you know, I asked, hey, can I go check it out? And they're like, well, unless you want to wear the suit, probably wouldn't be a good thing to be over there. And, you know, I'm a dog lover, but yeah, I'm not crazy enough to put on that suit and mess around with some of these dogs.
Yeah. Me neither at all. I have never been close to being attacked by a police dog, and I really don't intend to be.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing, right? It's kind of, you know, it's funny, but it's not funny. You know, especially when you see these high speed chases. You know, they release the dog, and they're telling the guy not to move, right? Yeah. You got a dog on you biting the hell out of you. How are you not going to move?
You know? Yeah,
and I just crack up. You know, it's like anytime I see that, it's like, guy should have just pulled over.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that is. Hey guys, so you heard it here. You can use airsoft for a bunch of different things. Do it for training. The police are even starting to use it. So we have no more excuses anymore. You need to start using airsoft for your training. For me, it was so easy to just get out in my backyard, even in your garage, to just shoot all day.
Now, when I say you can shoot it anywhere, you can shoot it anywhere, even at the range. You can shoot on a hill. While you grill.
Said, police are training. He uses it to train. Everyone uses it to train. Now get on that bandwagon and start shooting airsoft. Thank you, guys.
Hey guys, that was the interview with Andy Yoshida from Lancer Tactical. Go check them out and go check this pistol out. Make sure to go follow me on Instagram. I post a week early before I post a video or post any articles. Make sure to leave a comment down below on what you guys want to see next. Thank you. Sounds good.